Welcome to the talk on MacRecon-Net, a multiple acquisition context-based convolutional neural network for magnetic resonance image reconstruction using dynamic weight prediction. I'm R. Sri Prabha from Healthcare Technology Innovation Center, Indian Institute of Technology, Madras, India. Magnetic resonance imaging is a non-invasive modality well known for providing good soft tissue contrast. The reconstruction of fully sampled images from undersampled measurements to accelerate acquisition plays a critical role in MR imaging. Methods based on compressed sensing have been deployed in clinical environments, however, involve repeated parameter tweaking and iterative computations, leading to long reconstruction times. Recently, deep learning based algorithms have shown to provide faster and good quality MR image reconstruction. The fundamental challenge in translating these methods to an MRI workstation in a clinical setting is that these methods heavily depend on training data in learning the mapping from undersampled images to fully sampled target images. They suffer from a covariate shift in data distribution, wherein a model trained using images from a particular distribution tends to perform poorly on data from a different distribution. So can we address this fundamental challenge is the question mark. We introduce a few terms here so as to proceed. Typically, the model is trained with images from particular setting. So different sets of weights of convolutional neural networks are learned for training data with different input settings. We consider three such settings specific to MRI, namely anatomy under study, the acceleration factor for undersampling, and the undersampling mass pattern. The typical values of acceleration factors can be 2x, 5x, and so on. The undersampling pattern and anatomy under study are shown. We call any combination of one or more of these settings as acquisition context. Context-specific model or CSM is a model that is trained on a particular setting, that is a particular acquisition context. The model is evaluated with the same context. For instance, we could have a CSM on cardiac images, Gaussian undersampling, and 5x acceleration. A joint context model is a model trained using a large corpus of images obtained from various contexts. Unseen context is an acquisition context with which the model is evaluated and is not known by the network at train time. For instance, we could train the model on cardiac images with 4x acceleration and we test the images with 4.5x acceleration. Using these terms, we come back to our problem of flexibility of CNNs for MR reconstruction across contexts. The context-specific models, as the name says, are experts in their own context. They provide good accuracy when evaluated because they are already overfit to their context. CSMs must be trained separately for each acquisition context. For instance, two anatomical studies, five acceleration factors, and two undersampling patterns would generate 20 training contexts. When the number of contexts increase, the combinations also increase, and the CSMs to be stored grows large, putting a practical limitation, since they are not efficient in terms of storage. They cannot perform well on unseen context also due to covariate shift. And yes, separate model for each context, that is task-specific weights are obtained. On the other extreme, we have joint context model wherein images from as many contexts as possible are taken and the model is trained. For instance, we could create a large entity of training data from multiple contexts and train the model once. For JCN, the accuracy is not as good as the CSM, but they are memory efficient. Because one common weight set is being learned for all the contexts that we consider, JCNs do not perform well in unseen contexts, and no task-specific weights are obtained. In our work, we show that the proposed method inherits the benefits of both CSM and JCN. So how do we bring in this flexibility? By making the network aware of the acquisition context of each training image and by feeding the context information to the network along with the respective images. How do we do this? We define a context vector as a numerically encoded vector to represent an acquisition context. For example, it could take three entries indicating acceleration factors, study, the pattern, and so on. We use the auxiliary network that learns to map the context vector with the respective input target pair. This network is called the dynamic weight prediction network. The core idea of dynamic weight prediction is that instead of directly learning the model parameters of a Bayes deconstruction network, another network can be used to predict the weights of the Bayes networks to effectively handle multiple contexts. Advantage: we get different set of weights for different contexts and better accuracy. The model is storage efficient and it generalizes across unseen contexts also. We summarize our contribution as we propose a multiple acquisition context-based network for MR reconstruction called the MacRecon-Net, consisting of a reconstruction module and a dynamic weight prediction module. The reconstruction module performs undersample MRA reconstruction. The dynamic weight prediction module takes context vector as input and learns context-specific weights of the reconstruction module dynamically. We show that the proposed approach can handle multiple contexts involving input settings that we considered in our discussion so far. And we also consider three clinically relevant contexts and show that the proposed network outperforms JCMs and give competitive results with the context-specific models, both quantitatively and qualitatively. So in the problem formulation, a CNN-based MRA reconstruction can be formulated as an optimization problem as shown. In this, the first term enforces the desired image X to be well approximated by a CNN reconstruction. The CNN reconstruction X CNN is equal to CNN of XQ parameterized by WCNN, where WCNN is the network weight. And the second term enforces data fidelity in the k-space to ensure consistency with the acquired k-space measurement. We note here that the acquisition context is mapped to the CNN weight by the DWT function highlighted in green here. In our case, it's a neural network which learns this mapping. So the architecture of MAC is cascaded architecture. The top left figure shows the overall block diagram of the architecture. The reconstruction module at the bottom is a cascade of NC CNN blocks with residual connections and k-space data fidelity units in an alternating manner. And there are NC DWP blocks, and each DWP block learns the weights of the respective CNN. Top right shows one unit of DWP and CNN in the cascade, and each CNN has 5 convolution layers with nonlinear activation. The formulation of the cascaded unit and the dynamic weight prediction network is shown at the bottom. So during training, the loss calculated between the predicted reconstructed image and the fully sampled target image is backpropagated to learn the weights of the DWP block. And the weights of the MRA reconstruction network are not made learnable. As a result, the weight of the DWP module are based on not only on the context vector, but also on the image domain loss. At test time, the context-specific weights for the CNN are generated by multiplying the learned weights of the DWP with the context vector and adding the bias values of the DWP. So we consider two data sets in our experiment, the cardiac ACDC segmentation challenge data set and the MR brain T1 and FLAIR images. And we use L1 loss function for training. And we consider three contexts relevant to clinical scenarios, which we will be seeing in detail. In the first study, we keep the anatomical study fixed and we vary the undersampling pattern and the acceleration factor. This context is flexible to scenarios wherein Cartesian undersampling, which is practical to implement and simple to reconstruct, is preferred, and other kinds of undersampling like Gaussian, spiral, where higher accuracy metrics are preferred. The context vector has two elements. One dimension is the acceleration factor, and along the undersampling, along the other dimension, we have the undersampling mass pattern. There are 5 factors, acceleration factors and 2 patterns, and this amounts to 10 context-specific models, which we have used for comparison here. And for JCM, we take all the images of these contexts and train the reconstruction network alone. We see that the metrics are closer to that of the CSM, and the reconstructed images are qualitatively closer to the target. And this is indicated with the residual images at the right side with reduction in the error. In the second experiment, we fix the undersampling pattern, and we vary the acceleration factor and the anatomy under study. In this context, demonstrate the flexibility of our model for scenarios like multi-contrast MRI, wherein multiple sequences like T1, T2, proton density, weighted MRI of the same anatomy are acquired for diagnosis. So we see that in this case also the metrics are closer to the CSM and much better than the JCM. In the qualitative analysis, we see that in the highlighted regions regions marked with arrows, the improvement as far as recovery of details is better. So yet another experiment is the unseen case, the one in which the context is unseen at train time. So in this, we fix the anatomy under study, and we also fix the undersampling mass pattern, and we vary only the acceleration factor. We choose 5 specific acceleration factors for training, and while testing, we take 28 unseen contexts. So from 2.4 to 7.6, we vary in increments of 2. This generates 28 unseen contexts, and 26 out of 28 have shown improvements over the joint context model, and the performance were equivalent to that of the CSM. And for comparison, we have taken 7 CSM, and then we have tabulated, and the respective JCM is also shown. And the table shows that the proposed method shows improvement over the joint context model, and equivalent performance to that of the CSM is obtained. The same is noticed in the qualitative analysis also. And we have taken here, we have shown the 7.6 unseen context case. And in the box plot that we see, we have taken 14 unseen contexts, and we have plotted the PSNR and SSIM improvements over the joint context model. So in all these contexts, in all these experiments, we have seen consistent improvement over the joint context model and equivalent performance to that of the CSM. And in the conclusion, we see that a CNN-based MR reconstruction that exhibits flexibility to multiple acquisition contexts could be more appropriate for a clinical scenario. And the proposed MacRecon Net incorporates this flexibility to multiple contexts in a single model by using a dynamic weight prediction module to generate context-specific weights for MR reconstruction models. We are currently working for a journal extension of this work towards improving the architecture to suit more clinical scenarios and extend the model to complex and parallel MRI datasets, and many more experiments to come. Thank you.